Hare Krishna.
Weakness makes us hot-headed. Wickedness makes us cold-blooded. We all have various weaknesses: lust, anger, greed, envy, pride, illusion. And when these impulsive desires surge up within us, we may act in a hot-headed way. Say somebody is angry and they yell at someone. They speak very, very harshly. They act violently. Now this is bad. That is hot-headed. That person is hot-headed. And to be hot-headed is undesirable. But far worse than being hot-headed is to be cold-blooded. When somebody is cold-blooded, they just in a very calculated way plan how to pander or how to indulge in their lower desires, and how to do that in a way by which they can actually get away with it. That the other person will be completely victimized, they can cover their tracks, they won't be blamed. So when one gets a sense of delight in doing something bad, and when one uses all of one's intelligence in doing something bad, then that person is wicked. So we all will have weaknesses, but we needn't have wickedness. The Bhagavad-Gita talks about the difference when it talks about the demoniac nature. Krishna in the 9th chapter says, even if we give in to our weaknesses, we can be considered saintly if we remain devoted to Krishna. Api chet sudura acharo bhajate mam ananya bhak sadhureva samantavya samyag vyavasito hi saha. If we stay determined in the service of Krishna, then even if sudura acharo, even if we do terrible wrong things, still Krishna considers us saintly. Krishna says that such a person should be considered saintly. In contrast, when Krishna talks about the demoniac people in the 16th chapter, he says such people get a devilish delight in doing deadly things, in assassinating their opponents. Asau maya hatah shatrur hanishye chaparanapi ishvaro aham aham bhogi siddho aham balvan sukhi. So he says that a person thinks that I have eliminated this enemy, and I will eliminate that also, and in this way I will delight. And that is a terrible, terrible consciousness. That is a consciousness that can bedevil us, that can ruin us. And that's why we need to carefully avoid wickedness. The people who have weaknesses are reformable, but people who have wickedness are far, far more difficult to reform, because they have no desire to reform. In fact, their intelligence is used to justify how they are right and to continue doing what they are wrong. And for such people, sometimes shock treatment is required. The Bhagavad-Gita depicts how Duryodhan had to be fought against, and Duryodhan had to be eliminated by Arjun because he was wicked. He was not even slightly remorseful for all the atrocious wrongs that he had done. And such a wicked person, if allowed to rule, will wreak havoc in society. A weak person may hurt themselves and may occasionally hurt others, but the weak person will at least want to reform and will not cause that much damage. But a wicked person will wreak havoc in society. So, of course, the power of bhakti is so great that the weak can be reformed and even the wicked can be reformed if they want to be reformed. But Duryodhana had no interest in reforming, and thus he had to be disciplined. And that's why Krishna spoke to Arjun the Bhagavad Gita to ensure that he did not succumb to weakness in his heart by being compassionate against the wicked. Compassion is required for those with weakness, but not with wickedness. Thank you. Hare Krishna.